Today I will show you how to translate your YouTube videos and reach a more global audience by following a specific strategy. We will look at the advantages and disadvantages of translating YouTube videos. We will look at how to do it and the pitfalls you should avoid. Hello and welcome to the Tubics YouTube channel. I'm Jan Fassbender from Sogit YouTube, and let's first look at what you actually can translate, because you cannot translate everything. You can translate the title of the video and the video description, and you can add closed captions so everyone can understand what's spoken in the video. What you cannot translate are the thumbnail of the video, and you also cannot translate the audio of the video, so you can't upload different audio files for different languages. So we definitely have some limits what we can do with translating videos, but if we do it correctly, we can use the features that YouTube provides us to reach a more global audience. But before we dive into the strategy, let's first look how translated videos will actually look to the viewer. To enable subtitles for a video, click on the little gear icon on the bottom right of the video and select subtitles. There you will see all the available options. A lot of videos don't have subtitles, but they always have automatically generated subtitles. Click on these to see the subtitles generated by the YouTube algorithm. To then translate these subtitles, click on subtitles again, and you will see the option to automatically translate these subtitles in any language you like. If a video has subtitles provided by the creator, you will find them in the same menu and they will replace the automatically generated subtitles. But why would you want to translate your videos? Well, there are different, more and less obvious reasons for it. The most obvious is definitely you reach a more global, a broader audience. There are way more people who can understand your video if the video has closed captions. This can lead to a couple of advantages that you're probably not thinking of. For example, you can get higher CPMs, you can earn more money with your videos, because different countries usually have different CPMs depending on how rich or poor the country is. So if you come from a poorer country and have subtitles for languages from other countries where people might be richer and more interesting for the advertisers, you can get more money. Also, you have the potential for longer playback times. If a viewer clicks on your video and doesn't understand it, of course they will click away. But if you have subtitles for them, the chances that they will stay are way higher. But of course, there are also some disadvantages. First of all, the time, the effort, the money that you need to invest to translate your videos. You can either do it yourself and invest a lot of time, or you can have someone translate the subtitles for you. More on this later in the video. But this, of course, costs money. And then there's the question, is it worth it to invest all of this time and money? Because translating subtitles does take quite a bit of time. It's also harder to optimize for search because you have different search queries in different languages. We usually recommend one channel per language, more on this in this video. Other disadvantages come with the fact that you can only translate certain aspects of your videos. So you cannot translate the audio itself, so you will only have closed captions in your video. If you want different versions of your video with, for example, different speakers speaking in different languages over the video, you need different videos, and I would recommend, like I said, different channels for this. And you cannot translate the text on your thumbnails. So if you have text on your thumbnail, it will only be in one language. I would recommend to not use text on your thumbnails at all if you want to target different languages with one video. Especially if your thumbnails are very visual, you don't really need text and the title can explain everything. So you should definitely think about strategy before starting to translate your videos. Ask yourself a couple of questions. What are your goals? Do the translations pay off? Is your time or money well invested? Can your content even be translated for viewers that speak a different native language? Will they understand your content? And will the translations change and improve the viewer experience significantly? And of course, don't just randomly translate your content into different languages. look at which languages are actually most significant and important for you. You can look at the top countries report in YouTube Analytics. The standard time frame are 28 days. I would recommend you to look at a longer time frame to see trends in your analytics and to see which countries are most relevant for you. And a very important step in internationalizing your content is to optimize your content English first. You should write your title and your regular video description in English, even if your content isn't in English, and then add translations for different countries. This has the effect that if someone sees your video that you have a translation for, they will see the translation. But if they come from a language or a country where you don't have a translation for, they will see it in English, and the chances of them understanding your video are way higher. Now let's look into the actual techniques and where to translate your YouTube videos.
To add translations to your video, choose your video in the YouTube Studio, click on Details, and on the left side you will find the area Subtitles. Here you can add another language. So let's, for example, add German subtitles. We choose German from the list, and here you can add the subtitles in German. Now we have a couple of different options to add subtitles. You can upload a file, so you can upload subtitles that you've created in another software. You can type them in manually, or you can auto-translate the subtitles if you have English subtitles already. So let's click on Type Manually, and now we can see the English subtitles of the video and we can just translate them in German. If you don't have subtitles for your native language, you will need to specify the exact timings of the subtitles as well. But as you might have seen, it's not only possible to add subtitles in this menu. So if we close these subtitles, you can see we can also create title and description here. So if we click on Add here, we have the option to translate both the title of the video and the description of the video into another language as well.
But of course, translating your videos isn't the only way to reach more viewers on YouTube. If you're interested in growing your brand on YouTube, download our free YouTube Marketing for Businesses guide here. I hope you enjoyed this video and I could help you. That's it for me. Bye, Yoyan.